I think for the first time ever, I have too much lighting, but it's raining, so it's complete darkness otherwise. Today, I'm going to give you a nice tour of my pagan altar. Little disclaimer, this is my altar that was set up when I was, to be fair, when I moved in. It's been kind of like this the whole time, and then when I moved my room around I put this up here instead of like next to it, and at that time I was pagan and then moved into Wiccan, and then I have since left Wicca, which I'll put a link to up here somewhere. And I am now a druid, and we haven't got, well, I haven't got super far in my druid studies yet, so this might end up changing, it might not, so I thought I'd give you a tour of how I've been using it for at least the last 5 years, and it might change, and I don't know what it'll change to, so I'm just going to give you a tour as if this is how it's going to stay. So this, I have two altars. You will have seen at least another one in some of my videos when I'm talking about how I set up for Samhain or Yule. I did it for Vlogmas last year, definitely, and you might be seeing it in my Vlogtide introductions. And this is my second one, well, the main one. I'd say this is my first one and the other one is my second one, but that's where the magic happens. This is just kind of a storage space, which is why I can really give you a tour of it, because the other one changes literally with the seasons. This is my altar, my storage altar. There's a lot going on. You can kind of see this top shelf here. This is all of my shiny rock storage. If you want a shiny rock tour, let me know. But this is just where I keep all of my shiny rocks, and yes, I have alphabetized them. It's just a lot easier to find it than when they're in a big box all together. These are literally just plastic nuts and bolts sorters. This is the only one that isn't alphabetized because they're like my new ones. So I didn't want to buy a new crystal and then like move everything to make it fit in alphabetical order. So I just kind of have like a random one. There's one of them, and that's my handwriting. And here we have letters A to B-ish. There's some more of them, they're B to some C. Ah! We have some more C to G, and some of them are missing because I've used them for something and not put them back. G to M. M to R, and lots of movement. And then we have R to T, and that's my last box, and some T is in the first box that you saw that also has all the random stuff in it. That is a collection that I have built up over the last 11 years without buying any new ones in the last year or so. I have bought more crystals, but not new types of crystals, so I've just bought like more of what I already have for XYZ reasons, many, many reasons. Moving on. Oh, another little pouch of crystals. These are not mine. These were, can you identify these? And I can, and then they forgot to ask me about it. Next shelf is this kind of clusterfuck kind of thing that I've got going on, where I have, it's mostly candles, but also candles are everywhere in this space because I'm a druid. Start with the little things. I've got a little pendulum here, which is for divination. Mostly yes, no answers. I don't use like the 8 wheel. I just like show me yes, show me no, and then do that from there. Messel and porter. Porter and messel. Don't know which way around it is. This you've seen before in my incense making. I use it to obviously crush stuff up to make incense. And I also use it as a good like mixing thing. So when I've got my final blend, I'll just give it another once over in there, just to make it all blend together. And then I have a feather. I found this on the floor. A plastic tub with stars on it, which I hate this tub so much, but it holds tea lights very nicely. Because they're all scented, now they all smell like each other, but they also keep the smell in there. Then I have this little broom model. I also do actually have another broom. I'll show you it in a minute, I think. I'll forget. But I have another one over there. It looks like this, but bigger, and the handle is probably in proportion about that big. I have this as like to symbolise a broom rather than actually act as one, for if I'm dressing up an altar or doing anything that requires a broom. I can use symbolism instead. You can even see it. There we go. Now I have a wand. I forget what wood it is. And it's wound with copper wire and it looks really cool. I don't think I can get this out on camera, but this is my bowline, or my bowline. Pronunciation is not my strong point and the community argues over it, so it doesn't really matter. It is a crescent shaped blade, and it is serrated, and it is for cutting herbs, cutting candles. I've used it for and just like magical workings. It's not really like anathema, which you like point with. This is for like actually cutting stuff. Then I have this lovely box. I have lots of these boxes, wooden boxes with pentacles on, and it's empty. And I have this lovely wooden box with another golden pentacle on it, and it is empty. And then I have this lovely box, which is one of those like secret you can't open me boxes. So you have to slide the panel out and then open it. And this is full of, I'm never gonna shut this again. This is full of like ribbons that have come off of things. So if I need to tie anything together, if I need to give like an offering of like, I need to tie a knot for an offering or anything that involves knots. It's good to have just like ribbon and bits of string around. Some of them are shoelaces, some of them are lace off tags, gift sets, etc. Nothing special about it, it's just ribbon. It's also worth noting that if you are leaving ribbon as offerings, especially if you're out in public and tying it on a tree, make it biodegradable and not plastic. I'm gonna put these back just so I can have some space. We have this basket. These are two spell pouches that I have used and I need to dismantle and dispose of. Some pieces of string that I didn't put in the thing when I had the chance. Another pouch for if I want to do a spell pouch. And then all tea lights, they're all white. Some of them are this size. Some of them are this size. And then I literally have a bag of bags. This is just full of these, but in different shapes, colours, materials, sizes, closures, you name it. Just sometimes they're useful for putting like spell pouches in, sometimes they're useful just for holding things. Like if you have a small amount of crystals that you just want to hold together. They have many uses, they're just little bags. I don't know what else to say about little bags. And then I have a red pillar candle. Probably gonna burn this around Yule. And it's scented like red berries. Then we have this marvellous shelf, which is all of my incense ingredients. They're just jars of herbs. I'll show you some of the cool stuff. This is a jar of clover leaves. I have never used it, but it is new. I think spring and summer is probably when these will come out. These are orange rose petals from a rose bush that I grew myself. I have hops, like beer hops. Not used them yet, but they do have their uses. A small jar of Egyptian sand from a friend, because this is a bit ridiculous. I traded some Cornish sand for some Egyptian sand. Here's another one that I made. Here's some blackcurrant leaves, all messled and ported and ground up from my very own blackcurrant plant, which is still alive. It just drops leaves occasionally as it grows. Dragon's blood, there we go, that's cool. There's a small jar of dragon's blood. That is just an amber resin, but it's bright red and it smells really, really sweet. So it has a cool name. Other stuff that is on this shelf, if you don't like bones, look away now and I'll put a timestamp here for when to skip to. very cool raven skull that I have, ethically sourced from my local magic shop. And then last of all, my tarot deck. I have just the original Rider White tarot deck. I'm not fantastic at interpreting the cards, but I am fantastic at picking the right card, and then it usually makes sense when I look up the meaning in a book or on the internet. Those are kind of the shelves, and then we have under the shelves where I just have, can you see that? Yeah, those are some incense sticks. Then I have, ignore the hooks, just a glass plate for burning candles on. And then some large scented tea lights, which I made myself from the big tea lights, and I scented them myself using my oil burner. So this was just wild. So this has pentacles on the side, and then the thing where you put like a tea light inside. I took this off, put this on, because it fits, melted the candle, added some essential oils, and then took it off to set. So I guess with this in my hand, moving on to the next part, which is like this area of my altar. This just lives there. I don't know how well you can see it, that looks black to me in the viewfinder, but it lives right there. This was a box that I got for Christmas, and it's just full of like little trinkets that don't really have any purpose on their own, they just kind of supplement and symbolise stuff. And this is a Cornish penny, which I ruined by taking it to school for show and tell and then doing PE, and then it fell out of my pocket and then it got hit by a lawnmower. But I found it after it got hit by a lawnmower, so that's something. A little snake charm, some sea glass, a bell, and a hagstone. Got a little hole in it. These are more incense ingredients, they're just in test tube things. We've got arnica and cedar tips, and the other two are completely empty. And then I have a candle holder, which you can't really see. Let's use my white, there we go. It's like vines and leaves, and they're for bigger candles. So the bigger candles live in this drawer under here, which you also probably can't see, but I can take it out. This drawer that lives in there, and they're just dinner candles. And then above that, I have some large chunks of rock, so I have some black obsidian, chunk of fluorite, and a chunk of salt. It was a gift. There's a theme here, but another wooden box with a gold pentacle on the top. And in that, spell candles. I have black ones, green ones, peach ones, lots of purple ones, a couple of red ones. The final remaining shelf on this is just my my oils. Some of them are essential oils, some of them are fragrance oils. They're nothing really special, I literally just use them for scent. So I'll use them in my oil burner, which you've seen. And occasionally to scent a candle. Up the side, which you can kind of see but kind of not see, is just a jewellery holder, because I don't have a jewellery box really, and a lot of the jewellery I have is like spiritual related. So this is mostly like crystal jewellery. Again, I'm not going to introduce you to all of my jewellery, but all of my crystal jewellery is here. So like the crystal chip bracelets, that spiral thing, I've got a piece of blue lace agate here. Anything with a pentacle on it lives over here. On the other side is non-spiritual jewellery, because I don't need two different places for jewellery. I can just keep it all in the same place. And then I have this tea light holder, there's five of them. Jar of sand number one. Jar of sand number two. I underestimated how much sand I had. And then this is just more portable than this. Jar of conkers. I have yet to find a use for them, but they're really good for symbolism. And then I just have my books of shadows, which I will put a link up here somewhere, to more info about my books of shadows, because they're all different in some way. These four books of shadows live there, because there's a three there, one there, and then my other ones live across the other side of the room, because they don't look pretty enough to be here. The only other thing on that side of the altar is just these. They are sugar tongs, but I used them for incense making, and that was just the most available book. So that's been a tour of my pagan altar. I hope you've enjoyed it. I hope it's given you some ideas. I hope it's helped you understand what an altar can be. This isn't what everyone's altar looks like. Some people's altars are strictly magical and they are strictly for ritual and spell use. They're not for storage. Mine is for storage, and then I have a separate magical one, which the only thing worth showing you is just the video that I linked back at the start, because it's just that yellow cloth with a pentacle on it and then whatever I'm putting on to represent whatever I'm representing. Don't forget to like this video if you liked it. Drop a comment down below if you have any questions or comments, obviously, all down there. Subscribe to our channel if you haven't already and ring that notification bell so you get notified every single time I post a new video. Videos go up every Saturday at 6 p.m. UK time with at least one bonus video every single month, apart from next month, which is Vlogtide, and you're going to be getting one video every day throughout December for 21 days. See ya!